The Philippine Stock Exchange closes higher as traders brace for the central bank's policy decision on Thursday. Michelle Long has today's market action.
The MSCI benchmark for Asian stocks up for a fourth session to recover further from last week's meltdown on bets that the upcoming U.S. consumer price report out tonight will allow the Federal Reserve to start easing as soon as next month. Here at home, the PSE index picked up to 67.04 on bargain hunters ahead of a key central bank policy decision on Thursday.
I don't think that the BSP should go for a rate cut as what the governor noted in the Senate interview. Primary directive of the BSP is to contain inflation, and being data dependent, as what they said. As you know, inflation is still high. In fact, it actually surged to 4.4% in the prior month. So, in no way, from that key variable alone, that inflation is already contained. I understand that the BSP is receiving a lot of pressure. If you look at how the US dollar and peso exchange rate have been doing in the past couple of weeks, from a high of 58.8 like 3 or 4 weeks ago, it's now down to 57 or even sub 57. That movement alone indicates to me that a lot of investors are banking on a no cut.
In corporate stories, Jollibee reports solid second quarter earnings growth of 31% to 3.04 billion pesos, bringing first half profit to 5.7 billion. CEO Ernesto Tanmantiong says the group's momentum this year continues with what he described as excellent second quarter performance. The Philippine businesses of Jollibee, Chowking, and Manginasal brands outperformed their system-wide sales targets, while the international business delivered strong second quarter system-wide sales with robust growth in Europe, Middle East, and North America. As for their coffee and tea business, it improved sequentially and year-on-year, led by the coffee bean and tea leaf, which grew system-wide sales by 26% during the quarter. Meanwhile, Bloomberry Resort saw net income cut down by 62% to just 1.3 billion pesos in the April to June period due to continued weakness in the VIP segment, which was partially offset by the 3% increase of combined mass table and electronic gaming machine revenues across Solaire Resort Entertainment City and Solaire Resort North. Excluding the impact of Solaire North's pre-operating expenses, consolidated EBITDA would have declined by 20% instead of 33%. And Ayala Corporation posts a 21% jump in first half earnings to 22.3 billion pesos on the back of stronger contributions from BPI, Ayala Land, Globe Telecom, and ASEN, as well as improved earnings from AC Energy and Infrastructure. Excluding one-off items, core net income grew 18% to 24.3 billion pesos. Michelle Long, ABS-CBN News.